So we'll discuss about 8086 registers in detail in today's session. So we know that 8086 microprocessor consists of 14 registers in it for processing. So whenever you want to execute your program, you can make use of these registers. Okay, so they are categorized in 4 different ways. So all the 14 registers, so we can categorize those 14 registers in 4 different ways. So the first way is general purpose registers, and here comes the AX, BX, CX and DX registers. And the second category is index registers. Here comes the base pointer register, stack pointer, source index and destination index registers. And the third one is the segment registers. Here these 4 registers like the CS, SS, DS and extra segment comes into this category. And the fourth one is the status and control registers. Here comes the flag register as well as the instruction pointer. So by seeing the name, you can understand what is the actual use of these registers. So you can understand up to some extent what is the use of these registers. So for example, if we consider the general purpose registers, so these are used to store the results, temporary results in the processor. So whenever you are executing any instruction or whenever you are doing any computation, so that computation might be an arithmetic instruction or logical instruction or data transfer instructions. So there is temporary results may be there. To store those temporary results, these registers are used. So accessing the register is very easy for the processor, okay, compared to accessing the memory. So a processor can access these registers very easily. So these registers are used for storing the temporary results during any computation. And here, if you consider the general purpose registers, we have the flexibility of using them as either 16-bit registers or as 8-bit registers. Okay, the same AX register can be used as 16-bit register or as 2 8-bit registers. So those 2 8-bit registers are AL and AH. So AL is the lower byte and AH is the upper byte. So if you want to use them as 16-bit registers, you can represent them in the form of AX, BX, CX and DX. Okay, and if you want to use them as 8-bit registers, we have these representations AL, AH, BL, BH, CL, CH and DL, DH. So here we have the flexibility of using them as 8-bit registers or 16-bit registers. And coming to the specific functionality of each and every registers, so if you consider the AX register, you can also call it as accumulator register. So it is the default register for most of the arithmetic and logical instructions. So the, what is the default register means, for example, if you perform any addition operation, the result gets stored in the accumulator itself. Okay, or for example, if you perform multiplication operation, okay, so the instruction you use in the case of 8086 microprocessor is MUL instruction. So MUL, for example, if you write MUL BX, so that means the BX register contents gets multiplied with the AX register contents. So AX is a default register in the case of multiplication operation. Okay, and the result gets stored in the AX register if its size is 16 bits. And if the result is a 32-bit size, then the result gets stored in DX and AX register. Okay, so you can use this AX register. Why? Because it is going to generate a shortest machine code. That's why AX is used in most of the arithmetic and logical operations and data transfer operations. Accumulator register is used mainly for this purpose. And coming to the BX register, you can also call it as a base register. Okay, so base register means it is used to hold the memory address. So it can also serve as a pointer register. So apart from these 4 registers, you can also use the BX as a pointer register. Okay, so that is the use of BX register. And coming to the CX register, it is also called as count register. So for example, if you want to use a particular loop. So if you want to execute a subroutine, or if you want to repeat a particular instruction n number of times, you may use the loop concept. So loop is one instruction which we use in microprocessors, 8086 microprocessor. So if you want to repeat a loop for n number of times, you have to initialize CX with the number n. So for example, if you want to repeat a loop for 8 times, you have to initialize your CX with value 8. Okay, so this is used to decide how many times a loop should run. So that's why it is called as a count register. And it is also used in shift and rotate operations also. Okay, and the next DX register. So DX is a data register. It is used to hold the result of multiplication operation, and it is also used to hold the address of a port in port addressing modes. Okay, so DX is used as a default register to hold the address of IO devices while we are using the port addressing modes. Okay, so this is the use of general purpose registers. And coming to the next one, segment registers. So these are used to hold the starting address of the particular segments. So code is, memory is divided into 4 segments for easy accessing. So code segment, stack segment, data segment and extra segment. So if you want to execute a particular instruction, the processor goes to this particular segment, code segment, and fetches the instruction from there. And if you want to operate on data, it goes to this data segment and brings the data from this portion. So likewise, each segment have a particular base address. So that is nothing but starting address. So to access the code segment, the processor makes use of the contents of this register. And to access the stack segment, okay, so stack is used to store the temporary values while you are executing a subroutine. Okay, so to access that stack, it may use this stack segment register and SP register. Combinedly, it can use these two register to access the stack. And data segment register is used to access the data. Okay, and extra segment register is used to access the data, and it is mainly used in string operations. Okay, so these segment registers holds the starting address of each segment. Okay, and this is the use of segment registers. And coming to the index registers, they are index and pointer registers. So they are used to hold the memory addresses. So base pointer registers, it is used to store the starting address of the stack segment. And SP is used to hold the address of the stack top. And SI and DI, source index register and destination index registers, they are used in string manipulation operations. So if you want to move a string from one memory location to another memory location, and if you want string concatenation or string comparison operations, you can have. So in those operations, we can make use of this source index and destination index registers. And coming to the status and control registers, as the name tells you, they are used to indicate the status of the microprocessor, or they are used to control the behavior of the processor. Okay, and instruction pointer, with the help of CS and IP, we will go to that particular location to fetch the current instruction. So we can make use of CS and IP combination to get the current instruction onto the processor. Okay, so this is not under the control of the programmer. So this is under the control of system only. And flag register is used to indicate the status of a particular arithmetic and logical operation performed by the processor currently. And it is also used to control the behavior of the processor. And this is all about 8086 register.